good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, at the outset. And I am Dr. Asha Murthy, senior cardiologist from Chennai, from SIMS Institute, Chennai, and also the Best Minister Health Services. I would like to thank the scientific chairman, Dr. Parthasarathy Banerjee, and the organizing committee members for giving me the wonderful opportunity as a speaker in the International and the National Conference of CSI, Hyderabad. And the interesting topic which has given to me is how to prevent complications in the pregnancy with the cardiac diseases. So, as you know that in women with the cardiovascular pathology such as a congenital heart disease, acquired heart disease, a timely counseling is very important, and outcomes is almost good if you take into consideration to doing it first and doing a pre-counseling, pre-pregnancy counseling. In contrast, you know, the maternal mortality is very high in the women with the acquired diseases, acquired heart diseases, with the present, those who present with the pregnancy, such as acute coronary syndrome or aortic dissection. Our worry is that the prevalence of acquired cardiovascular disease is rising. It is a day of concern because of the older maternal age, obesity, diabetes, mellitus, hypertension, which is becoming a very common in the pregnant population. So the pregnancy is one of the, pregnancy can lead to the complications in the women with the heart disease, and also these complications can also be life-threatening. Understanding the serious complications and how they can be prevented is very important, because the cardiovascular disease is the leading cause of pregnancy-related mortality in the United States and also in the European countries and also in the developing countries, India, where there is about 7.2 to 17.2 deaths per 1 lakh live births. It is a rising trend from 1987 to 2020. And as you know, the cardiovascular diseases, it complicates almost 1 to 4% of pregnancy with the higher prevalence with the, when there is a associated hypertensive disorders, which is accounting for the increase in mortality, which is accounting for the increased mortality and leading cause of death in the pregnant woman in the developed countries. And before understanding to the complications of the cardiac diseases, I would like to highlight that there is some physiological change which occurs during the pregnancy. There is an increase in the cardiac output. There is increase in the heart rate. There is, as consequence, the stroke volume increases. But there is a fall in the systemic vascular resistance. The systolic blood pressure will fall. The peripheral vascular resistance will fall. And as you know, this peaks over due to 3 to 4 weeks. Almost we encounter congenital heart disease, cyanotic heart disease, acyanotic heart disease, acquired disease like mitral valve disease, aortic valve disease, and acute ischemic heart disease, in which you have a severe aortic stenosis, hypertrophy, obstructive cardiomyopathy, peripartum cardiomyopathy. All these are very common disorders which can be encountered during pregnancy and pulmonary embolism. So hypertensive gestation, hypertension management can be done with the beta blockers, with the labetalol, methyl dopa. Metoprolol and indoropropanol should be avoided. And nifedipine can also, calcium channel blockers, nifedipine, diltiazem can be given to the patients. These patients have to be monitored throughout the pregnancy to avoid any complications encountered. Number two, the patients who have got acquired heart disease, like mild to moderate mitral stenosis, mild to moderate mitral regurgitation, aortic regurgitation, they are tolerated well. Only if there is a severe aortic regurgitation, severe aortic stenosis, or associated with the severe pulmonary hypertension, severe mitral stenosis. Some patients, these tight stenosis can undergo a balloon valvuloplasty during the midterm pregnancy so that to avoid any pulmonary edema during the end. So my advice is those mild to moderate can be tolerated, they tolerate the pregnancy well. But those who are with the severe disease, they have to be titrated and they have to be monitored well regularly during the pregnancy and go for a procedure if possible. Similarly, the shunt, that cyanotic heart disease, these patients with a severe cyanosis, the saturation less than 85 to 90%, these patients have to be monitored and they should be advised not to undergo the pregnancy. But mild cyanosis, they tolerate the pregnancy and then can be allowed till the term pregnancy with the due dates. But those patients with cyanotic heart disease, like tetralogy of Fallot, a severe tetralogy of Fallot, transposition of great vessels, double outer right ventricle. These are some of the complications which should be avoided. Pregnancy should be avoided. Similarly, Eisenmenger syndrome, where there's a severe pulmonary hypertension, they face as increasing in the maternal and fetal mortality. So it should be avoided. But if the patient becomes pregnant, you have to monitor. So this requires, there is an increase. This requires a continuous cardio obstetricians with the monitoring throughout the pregnancy. So the medical conditions which can be in brief, which can be encountered as a hypertensive disorders in pregnancy, hypercholesterolemia, which can be managed with the drugs later on because statins are not to be given in the pregnant patients. Ischemic heart disease, the patients can become with acute coronary syndrome with the aortic subaortic dissection. So in such situation, you have to undergo the angiogram and do the necessary treatment. Arrhythmias can be managed with the medications with diltiazem and with the verapamil and with the amiodarone drug. Valvular heart disease, as I mentioned to you now, that those severe obstructions has to be dealt and should be avoided pregnancy. The deep in thrombosis patients who are coming in the pulmonary embolism in pregnancy, they have to be managed with the anticoagulants and they have to be given intravenous and then managed accordingly. So cerebral vascular disease in pregnancy can also be encountered and they have to manage accordingly. So we are following the European Society of Cardiology guidelines of pregnant patients of 2018-2020 in which patient who come with a severe hypertension, a vaginal delivery as we planned, or whether the patient is cesarean section, this all has to be planned accordingly to the depends upon the patient scenario. What is the clinical scenario of the patient? So those patients with the severe obstructions like aortic dissection, Eisenmenger disease, severe heart failure, all these patients directed cardiomyopathy with a severe ejection fraction of less than 30%. All these patients have to undergo safely a cesarean section and deliver the baby. And you have to do a routine electrocardiogram and guide your monitoring with the echocardiogram. And CT electrophysiological studies can be done with those patients with the arrhythmias. And bypass or angioplasty can be done can be planned later on once the patient delivers. So a prophylactic antibiotic has to be given to prevent endocardial prophylaxis. So my key message is that, ladies and gentlemen, the pregnant woman with the heart disease at a risk for serious and life-threatening cardiac and obstetric complications. Number one, approximately about one half of these cardiac events are preventable. Of course, the strategies to prevent the serious maternal cardiac complications is high-risk cohort of women needs to be developed. Advancing maternal age and pre-existing comorbidity, including congenital heart disease, are increasing, contributing to the rates of higher maternal mortality. So preconception counseling and early involvement in the multidisciplinary, please listen to me, multidisciplinary cardio-obstetric team are warranted in order to provide a comprehensive maternal and fetal risk associated with the pregnancy. And in women with the high-risk pregnancy, a cardio-obstetric team is essential to prevent further maternal morbidity and mortality during the length of pregnancy and postpartum. So, the pre-assumption is that there are some criteria of events which can be checked before the patients monitored, like the those patients who are coming with the severe NYHA class, like for example, patient is having some severe cyanosis or saturation is down. So all these parameters have to be clinical symptoms has to be assessed before giving the right to deliver, whether the patient can go for a vaginal delivery or patient can go for cesarean section. So pre-genetic counseling is very essential. And my request is that all patients should go for a counseling, the pre-genetic, the pre-pregnancy counseling, whether they should undergo a pregnancy or whether they have to be followed up with this. I thank you very much once again for giving me this opportunity to speak on this CSI TV sponsored by Sleep. Thank you very much.